Owl fans, welcome to Hootie Who, Impact Media's weekly roundup of football, hockey, and rugby from our Kennesaw State Owls. I'm your host, Jeremy the Impact York. Yep, told you guys I was due to get another hat at the football game. This is the one I got. I know what you guys are saying. It's got these little ear flaps that come down, which makes it pretty cool. But I like them up because looks like a cool helmet. This is our cool helmet. Here we go. Just so you guys know what it looks like. I think this is a cool hat. I think this is a really cool hat. I saw some awesome young kids wearing it, and I decided I had to have it. It's very affordable, by the way. Man, theme of this show is put your helmet on. Put your helmet on. It's ready to go to work. We're ready to go to work. We're ready to go to work. Let's go. Let's get it, you know, Owls. We're going to fly. We're going to fly. We're going to talk about rugby. Some of you saw my update from the hockey arena that is coming up. It's coming up as well. If you didn't see the update, go check it out. It should be on a lot of our social medias. I need to post it to not Twitter, TikTok. I need to put it on TikTok. This all there. I never know what this thing. All right. I need to post it to Twitter. And, oh, no, it's on Twitter. I need to post it to TikTok. You guys said you want to see more videos there. We will try to post some more there. Tons and tons we are going to get into. Let's go ahead and get into this. Oh, if you want to follow the show, Impact_Media_ on YouTube. The Impact 99 on practically any social media and any of that. You will be able to find all of our amazing content. We just finished up the UGA show, if you follow them a little bit. Other things coming this week, we're going to have that Atlanta Sports Show. We're going to have Up of the White and Gold. We will also the debut of Board Check because, hey, hockey's coming. Hockey's underway for almost every level but the NHL. Technically, it started, but we're going to have – I'm missing a show somewhere. What am I missing? I'm missing – oh, we're going to have Strong Style. And we will also have a AEW pay-per-view preview show coming up probably Thursday. All of that coming up this week. Busy, busy time. Let's get right into it. It looks like I'm wearing a rugby helmet, which I sort of am. So let's talk about rugby. You know, over the weekend, they went down to the Bayou at LSU and were able to they got a try. I'm not saying that I didn't think they could do it, but they were able to put up some points on LSU. They come up just short of the victory, but man, I thought they did a good job. I thought they battled hard. Coach Matt's got them really doing well, and I think they are definitely ahead of where they were at this time last year. So I look forward to the things they're going to do throughout the year, including they have a game this weekend. I believe it is at the field that is behind the visitor stands at Fifth Third Bank Stadium. And if I'm not mistaken, that's going to kick off around 10:30 this Saturday morning. And last time I checked, my schedule's clear at that time. So I'm gonna try to get by this game. I'm gonna check with Coach Matt, make sure that I got all the times and everything, and we'll post up any kind of update as far as that. But you might see this guy down there at the rugby match. Can't wait! I have not seen live rugby in a while, and I miss it. And I miss KSU rugby. So I'm gonna go remedy both of those things. Would love to see you guys down there as well. You know, come check it out and let us know how. Let us know what you think. Come say hello. Come tell me my hat's awesome, because that's the only thing you can say about my hat that I will believe, is that it is totally awesome. And like I said, come see us down there. Let's get into KSU football. They played against Jacksonville State. We're doing a pretty good job of staying with them until late. And then they ran into the buzzsaw that is former Fullman? Furman. Not Foleman. Furman, quarterback. Huff, I believe is his name. Yeah, Tyler Huff. He torched the Owls last year for three or four touchdowns, and he did the same here. He rushed for three. Trey Stewart rushed for one, and Mike Franklin rushed for the other. Let's see, eight. I think they threw for one. As no, they didn't throw for one. They ran for all of their touchdowns, except for the pick six. But man, all the momentum KSU had at the end of the second half, they blocked a field goal. They were able to score a couple times right towards the end, including right in front of me. I need to post those videos. That was right in front of me when they scored right before halftime. And lots of cameras, lots of attention. That's what this year is going to be about. It's about growing and building. And you're going to be on TV at least three times in the week in midweek games. No, four times. 4 out of the 5 weeks in October, you are going to be on national television. Welcome to the big time. Welcome to Conference USA. There were some things I liked for sure. Davis Bryson is continuing to dig. He puts his helmet on and he goes out there and he works hard. Michael Benefield had a great game, 17 carries, 112 yards. He had a big touchdown. Quay Ashley returned a kickoff all the way back for a touchdown. That happened in front of me too. I didn't get a video of that, unfortunately. I was too busy just coming out of my seat because could not. We just looked up and he was just torching people and it was crazy. We talked to him after the game. We talked to is it Mylon or Milan? I keep getting two different things. I think it's Mylon. We talked to Mylon Jones and we talked to coach as well. And they still had some good positive things to say. They haven't given up. They keep fighting hard. They know they're so close to really turning this thing, and it just not quite their day. Just not quite their day. At some point, the passing game is going to really step up. They're getting closer and closer, but run blocking and pass blocking are two different things. This offensive line does pretty well with the run. They're getting better at pass blocking. They still need a little bit of work, but that they're not terrible at all. They're actually pretty good. And if they can give Davis Bryson enough time to unleash some passes, then I think we'll really be cooking with gas here. On the defensive side, like I said, Mylon had 12 total tackles, I believe. Denelius Johnson had a big game. Javen Williams, Garland Binyard, just big tackle monster days. Austin Welch hit the one field goal. He went for it and all of his extra points. That's a big thing. Jacob Ulrich continues to do 42, 44, 45 plus yard punts. He was doing a good job of pinning Jacksonville State back when he could. But in the end, Jacksonville State's a big team. They're a big time team. It's a small story. I almost went to school there out of high school because I was a marching band kid in percussion, and Jacksonville State still has one of the top in the area percussion programs. Now, Kennesaw's got a dang good one too. I would have liked to see the two of them battle because they were both on point. Both bands were on this night. It would have been fantastic. But instead of going to Jack State, I decided to be an Owl. That's kind of my high school story there. There's a lot more to it, but I guess I'll have to read my book to do that. I haven't wrote it yet. I guarantee it'll be funny. But I said this team, they're just right there on the edge, I think. As I said last week, to see the passion and how much the players and Coach Bo actually care. Because they could easily pack it in right now and just coast through the rest of the year and great, you know, cash in my scholarships or some of them could transfer to other people. That's not who they are. That's not who they are. Remember, this program started with the likes of Chandler Burks and others redshirting, the entire team redshirting in the first year. Redshirting and saying, well, all we're going to do is practice against each other because next year when we're all eligible, we're gonna have that whole year together. And look at how it went, you know? Look at how it went. I think that team is not at a restart, but I think they are rediscovering their self. And I think having this week as a bye week is going to help. And then next Tuesday, a week from tomorrow, they will be at Middle Tennessee State, 8 p.m. game. It's a winnable game, CBS Sports Network. We'll see what's going on that day. We may tweet along with that one, and you guys can follow us on X. Or we may just watch the game and see how it plays out. I'm not sure yet, but it's going to start a fun gauntlet of games. Like I said, they're off this week. Then next Tuesday, the 15th, they play at 8. The following Wednesday at home will be a 7 o'clock game, and the following Wednesday after that is a ESPN2 7:30 game versus Western Kentucky. So. Okay, that's good. I just thought I was going to have a conflict there. They can beat Middle Tennessee State. Middle Tennessee State is looking at 1-4, and that's not why I think they can beat them. Middle Tennessee State is having a similar year to Kennesaw. They are trying to get some things going. They've got Batayo? Batato? Their quarterback, he's thrown for over 1,200 yards, but he's also threw five interceptions. I mean, four interceptions and five touchdowns, you know. Here's the fun thing is if I'm not mistaken, one of their main quarterbacks is Jaden Cradle. I think he might be related to, don't know if he is or not. He might be related to Chris Cradle from Georgia State. Plays a lot like him. So, but either way, that thing's going to be in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. We will talk more next week about it. Don't give up on this team. Don't give up on this team. This team, they put their helmets on and they go to work. And that's what coach is going to have them do. And that's what the players say at the press conferences, regardless of win, lose, draw. Every week, we come in every morning, we put our helmets on, and we go to work. And that's what this team's doing. Just like the rugby team, just like the hockey team, who over the weekend, they beat Georgia Tech 6-3 on Friday night. They lost 6-4, I believe, on Saturday night. But think about that. They scored 10 to Georgia Tech's 9. So technically, they won that. If this was bowling, they would have picked up the extra point. It's not bowling. But this team, man, this team's going to be something special. We went by to see our setup and what kind of things are going to be possible at the Atlanta Ice House. It looks like our squad will be split up a little bit, that me and Wheels may be on the other side on some high rises that, I'll be honest, look a little sketchy, but I think they're going to be okay, and it's going to give you guys such an amazing experience. And if you come to games, there's a chance you can sit right down below us. So it'll be great to be right in the middle of all you guys at these games, just like we are at the football games. We're going to be right in the middle of the crowd at the rugby. Just come hang out. Come say hello. Come cheer on these amazing athletes, these young men, these future leaders of our communities. And I can't wait. I can't wait. We get a week off, and it'll be next week when KSU will kick off their homestand. Please come to the Atlanta Ice House and check those out. That will be Friday night and Saturday night of next weekend. And for people who don't know where the Atlanta Ice House is, if you're coming up Barrett Parkway, this is the easiest way. Go like you're going to the mall, but instead, cross over 75, cross or cross under 75, cross under 575. Go like you're going to Mount Asia, which is on the right. Go up the hill a little bit. Go like you're going to the Barnes and Noble. You guys know where the Barnes and Noble is. I think there's a B-Dubs on the right as well, but on the left is Barnes and Noble. Turn right before the Barnes and Noble. That's Prado Lane. Go behind the Ross, and there's the Atlanta Ice House. It's a fantastic venue. I went and checked it out. The ice looked like in good shape. Really, really fun venue. They got some cool stuff coming up. I told them I was going to mention it. They've got some Halloween parties, some free skates, some DJs, live DJ music and stuff like that. So you guys go to the Atlanta Ice House even when there's not KSU games. Go check that out. Tell them the Impact sent you. They'll know who it is. And I think we've reached the end of our contest. Shout out to all the amazing people who tune into this show each and every week. And shout out to the amazing young ladies that sold me this hat. I'm going to wear this hat maybe the rest of the night. I'm going to wear it a lot more than that. Might even wear it Saturday. Who knows? But as I said, come by and see us at the rugby game. I'm going to do my best to come by there. Hockey starts next week with the homestand. They're already 1-1. But they start with a homestand next week, and football is off, and then we will see them next Tuesday versus Middle Tennessee State. But this is another great edition of Hootie Who. We will see you guys next week. Deuces, gooses. Go Owls.